Let's work through a word problem involving velocity vectors. So here's a situation. The water in a stream flows south at a speed of 5 miles per hour. A duckling is swimming straight east across the stream at a speed of 3 miles per hour relative to the water. What is the speed and direction of the duckling's travel relative to the shore? Okay, so what's the general situation here? Well, we have a stream, right, and it's flowing south. And then we have a little duckling who is trying to swim across the stream. And relative to the water, the duckling is swimming straight east. Relative to the water just means the speed and direction that the duck would be going if the water was still. So, because of the current, the duckling isn't actually going to be moving straight across the stream, though, right? It's going to have a movement somewhere in this general direction, and that's what we're looking for. We're looking to know about that vector, which is what we call the speed and direction of the duckling's travel relative to the shore, or how it would look to someone standing on the ground. So that's our goal here, is to figure that out. So there's a useful relationship that we're going to use here. So that relationship is that the velocity relative to the ground is going to equal the velocity relative to the water plus the velocity of the current. And we're looking for the velocity relative to the ground. Okay, so to make this a little bit easier to work with the vectors, let's actually set this up on the coordinate plane. Okay, so let's put our vectors on this graph. So what we know is we know the vector of movement relative to the water, and then also the vector that represents the current of the water. So we know that the stream flows south at a speed of 5 miles per hour. So 5 is the magnitude of that vector, and then south is the direction. So I'm going to kind of go with the standard north, south, east, west, and make south the negative y direction. So then what we're going to have here is we're going to have a vector pointing south with a magnitude of 5. Okay, and this is going to be the current vector. Okay, and if I write that current vector component-wise, it's going to be 0, negative 5, right, because it's purely in the y direction. Okay, so we can do the same thing for the velocity of the duck relative to the water. So it says it's swimming straight east across the stream at a speed of 3 miles per hour relative to the water. Okay, so straight east, that's going to be in the positive x direction, and magnitude of 3. So we've got this, and this is the velocity relative to the water. And if I write that by components, that's going to be 3 comma 0. Now what we want to do is we want to add these vectors to get the velocity relative to the ground. So let's just add them component-wise. So I'm interested in what I'm calling VC plus VW. Okay, so VC was 0, negative 5. VW was 3, 0. So if I add those, I get the vector 3, negative 5. Okay, so let's just sketch that in on our picture. We can see if it looks reasonable. So let's see, that should look like this, and that kind of looks like what we were expecting. Okay, so we're saying that this should be the velocity of the duckling relative to the ground, the vector 3, negative 5. Okay, so now that we have the vector, we're not quite done, because look at what it's asking. It's asking what is the speed and direction of the duckling's travel. So we need to actually find the magnitude of this vector, and that's going to give us a speed. And as far as the direction, we're going to end up describing that by an angle, which is kind of standard in these sort of problems. But let's start with the speed. So once again, the speed. So I'm looking for speed of duckling's travel relative to the ground. And that's simply going to be the magnitude of this VG vector. Okay, well, that's not too bad, right? Because we have it by components, so it's just going to be the square root of 3 squared plus negative 5 squared. So that's the square root of 9 plus 25, or the square root of 34, which is approximately 5.83, and miles per hour is our units. Okay, so this is the speed of the duck relative to the ground. So this is part of our answer. Now, the other thing that we're interested in is the direction, of the duck's travel. Now, we can see what it is from this picture, right? But let's try to describe that in words. And often how that's described is as an angle. So you can see that we have a triangle here, right? Well, there's actually two triangles, and we could use either one, but I'm going to use this triangle here. And I'm going to try and compute this angle here. I'm going to call it theta, and then I'm going to use that angle to describe the direction. So I'm just going to reproduce this triangle down here, just so we have a little bit more detail. So I know this side is 3. I'm just taking this right from my picture. I know this side is 5, and I just figured out that this side, we just computed the magnitude of that vector, was a square root of 34. And this is a right triangle, right? I've got this right angle here. And I'm interested in computing this angle theta. Okay, so there are lots of ways you can do this. You can use sine, cosine, tangent, whatever. I'm going to use a tangent. So I know that the tangent of theta, so tangent is opposite over adjacent, so tangent of theta is 3/5. And then to figure out what theta is, I can take the inverse tangent of both sides. So end up with theta equals the arctan, or the inverse tan, of 5/3. Okay, and if you put that in your calculator, in degrees, you're going to get about 59.04 degrees. Okay, so that gives us this angle. We want to describe what that angle is, though. So a way you could report your final answer is maybe something like this. So the duckling is moving about 59.04 degrees. We could say, if you look at this angle, we could describe this as south of east. South of east at a speed of 5.83 miles per hour relative to the ground. All right, and then that's our final answer right there. That tells us about the duck's motion relative to the ground.